Hey friends, welcome to Tech for Beginners, and in today video I'm gonna do a review of the Gen Next ROM for Samsung. This is the stock ROM for Samsung and it covers various features and comes with the Android 4.2.2, so stay tuned for the video. So guys, let's start with the phone dialer, and it provides the various keypad, the logs, the favorites becomes by contacting most of the people, so it becomes the favorites and the contacts with the pictures, and you can also do the voice video call as well as the voice call. So you can switch on the back camera or switch on your front camera that is appropriate for you, and also it's very minimalistic and simplistic keypad that is provided by the Samsung stock firmware Android 4.2. So let's move ahead with the default messaging app that the Samsung provides. So this is basically all the Samsung, this is the messages that they displayed. You can also enter the recipient and the message, but there are many ways on adding a message with this standard keyboard. You can go to the settings and there are various options like key type of sound, cursor control, continuous input and the text. So by turning on the continuous input, you can slide across the various words in the standard keyboard pad, and this will give you a result and adjoin a word for you, and like this the example is going on. So you can just make a curve with your finger or make a straight line. You can slide across any point of your finger in any word and the message will go on. So it's the easiest way to do this. You can also attach the attachments like image, pictures, video, videos, audios, memo, planner, etc. So guys, let's move on to the video player that is provided by the Samsung, and there are various videos pre-installed on my phone. So let's start with the Britney Spears. And so when you open the video, you can play it in the portrait mode, in the landscape mode, and there are various new features that you can zoom in and zoom out by pinching in your finger to it, and you can also select the modes for running of it, and also you can play the video in the home screen of yours while running your phone. You can also watch the video and zoom in and zoom out. So guys, let's move on to the settings. There are connection, my device, accounts and more. So in the connection, there are Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, data usage, more networks, nearby devices, etc. So in the when we go in the more devices, there are tethering and portable hotspot, VPN, mobile networks, etc. So you can make a portable Wi-Fi hotspot and USB tethering, and also do the Bluetooth tethering, but it will not share the internet of your phone. Also you can set up a VPN. Go back, you can also search in the my device. There are lock screen, display, sound, home screen, call, driving mode, blocking mode, power saving mode, accessibility, one-handed operation, language and input, motion and gestures, and smart screen. So when you go into the lock screen, you see the various effects, unlock effects, multiple widgets, lock screen widgets. Also you can wake up, set a wake up command for your lock screen to wake up, and you can add the multiple widgets, and also you can change the effect. So when we go into the display, we see that there are wallpapers, notification panels, also the multi window feature that is most popular on the Samsung device. Also adjust the brightness, the rotate screen, the font size, touch key light duration, battery percentage, and edit after screen capture. Also you have the sound. In the sound, when you can adjust the volume, your ringtones, your vibrations, you can also select that, dialing, keypad tones, touch sounds, screen lock sounds. So also you have the home screen mode. There are two modes, standard mode as well as easy mode. Easy mode will guide you through the phone of yours, and standard mode, as I'm using the standard mode. And you also have the call option, where you can just select the call rejection on answering ending calls, or additional settings are there. Also set the ringtones, increase your volume also, and voicemail services also provided in your accounts. So you can also do the call rejection. There's auto reject mode, where you can select the numbers which you want to auto reject. Also there's blocking mode, driving mode, SIM card manager, power saving mode which saves your power, and use low power level for your screen and limit the maximum performance of your CPU. Also there is accessibility, in which there is screen timeout, auto rotate screen. You can also speak the passwords. You can also answer end calls. You can talk back. There are also the magnification gestures. It basically provides the gestures. You can triple tap your home screen and it will zoom in the home screen and will show you the each and everything. You can also do the sound balance. So let's do the demo for the magnification gestures. So when I triple tap on my phone, it's basically zoom in and will show the all the options running on my phone. So when we go to the one hand operation, there are basically the keypad, in and call buttons, calculator, unlock pattern, with enable to adjust the scale of the these three options to use it with one hand. So also there are language and input which we can select the default language, also the Google voice typing, voice recognition service, sir. Also text to speed option is also provided and you can change the pointer speed. Okay, so there are also the motion and gestures for your phone. There's the motion, palm motion, and gyroscope calibration. So you can control your device with the natural movement in the motion. Palm motion, you can control your hand device with your hand, and in the you can calibrate motion correctly using gyroscope. So let's move ahead. You also have the smart screen. The screen stays on as long as you are looking at it. So by turning it on, it will be awake when your eye is in there, and if you remove your eye from it, the screen will turn off. Your account with these all, Facebook, Google, WhatsApp, or you can add your own account. Let's go to the more. There are location services, security, application manager. So let's go to the location settings. You can access to my location, then the Google will find you on location. In the security, you can encrypt your data, you encrypt your device. You can set the screen lock type. You can remote control. You can change the SIM. You can set up SIM card lock. You can also make the passwords visible, and there are unknown sources. When you will take these unknown sources, you can download the applications from the external sources like the browsers. Also, when it's the battery, will show the battery, how much it's consumed and by how much part it is consumed, and also provides the hours and minutes for it. When you go to the storage, it will show the storage total space it provided by the 8 GB, and it catches data, available space, use space, and system memory as well. So where you can also check the date and time by clicking on the automatic date and time. It will set the date and time automatically by your standard time. In the developer options, you can do the desktop backup password, stay awake. You can protect your SD card, do the USB debugging, select your debug app. You can verify apps via USB. Show touches will show the touches of your phone, and you can also show the pointer location, show layout boundaries, show GPU view updates, show hardware, show GPU overdraw, show screen updates, and also there are the animation scales. So by doing these animations, since your phone gets very slow and sluggish, so I recommend to set this at default by this. So basically all these will do the one, and it will do all the work. So when we come down, we see all the options like strict mode, show CPU usage, provide GPU rendering, enable traces, and external things that are provided by this. When we go to the about device, we see the software updates are also there, so you can check about the updates. Auto updates are also you can check on that, and the Wi-Fi only is also provided. You can check also the status of your phone, by which it tells you the Wi-Fi address, your IP address, your phone number, or your operator info, etc. So you can check the license from your open sources, and there you can change your device name by typing in. And also it provides the model number, your Android version or baseband version or kernel version or your build number. So you can check on that. So it is now 4.2.2 that this ROM provides. So all the options are being provided by this phone, and you can check for all the settings that are provided by this stock ROM. So let's move ahead to the other feature. Let's move on to the camera. As I am using Samsung Galaxy Grand Duo, so it has the 8 megapixel camera. In the camera, it takes a nice and decent photo with the details on it and great saturation, so you can turn on and turn off the flash, and while we click the photo with the flash, there the maximum difference. So this is the flash photo and this is the ordinary one. So you can also shoot the video. It shoots, my phone shoots the video at 1080p, that is the full HD, in the full HD resolution. So you can, and also you can add the various settings like GPS tag, self portrait flash, your shooting mode or your effects. So in the shooting mode there is continuous shot, face detection, panorama, share shot, body show share and beauty and smile shot. So these all are the software provided by this phone. Also you can add the various effects like cold vintage, warm vintage, etc. So cold will give you a blue and warm will give you orangish color. So let's take a video for that in the flash on. So you can check that photo, that is really really cool. And the camera software also and the hardware is really good. So I have also shooted a video so here is the sample video that I shooted. So you can play with the photos of the video player and just select the one that you want to play, and here it comes. So it's the nice camera. Also this is the laptop of mine which I have shooted, and it's the 14 second video which I have shooted in the 1080p full HD resolution. So basically it shoots the video very well. So till now this ROM is working quite perfectly and giving a great performance. So let's do a gaming on it. We have the Temple Run running, and so let's start the gaming. And the game is like running game, and it was the first game running game and which got very famous. So we are seeing no lag on it and the game is running smoothly. As I'm using the screen recorder, so might be a lag, but in my phone and in this ROM it runs quite smoothly and there is no lag on it. You can play the heavy games also in this phone or this ROM. This is appropriate ROM for running that. You can play the GTA San Andreas, GTA Vice City, GTA Liberty City, the Dragon games, in the arcade games, the action games, Frontline Commando, like also you can play Shadowgun, MC, the Modern Combat 4, Modern Combat 3, Game Loft, all the Game Loft games and all the big games, heavy games runs perfectly on it. So here's the bit of the gameplay for you. So guys, this, so by turning on the multi-window feature, this various apps would provide like gallery, your video, your browser, your maps, your memo, etc. So let's choose the video app and drag it to the home screen, and so here the video will come. And then for the multi-window use, you can choose any of the service that want to use, for example the gallery. So in one screen we can use the two of the apps, and on the above we can play the video, and in the down we can see the images or zoom in and zoom out of the wallpapers, and on the above section we can watch the video. So here are how it works, and this is the sample video for you. So guys, this was a review of the Samsung stock ROM Gen X, and I have almost covered all the features and the settings which comes with this ROM. If you have any more thoughts, then please comment your say. Thanks for watching, and please hit that like button if you like this. Subscribe for more videos like that.